guys, Jonathan here. Today we are going to talk about one of the most popular rubber sealing materials, nitrile rubber. Nitrile rubber is also known as buna-n, buna-n, acrylonitrile butadiene rubber, and NBR. And buna is the commercial trademark of Lanxess. Personally, I prefer calling nitrile rubber as NBR or nitrile. To understand the function of buna, let's go over a brief history of NBR. The reason to develop NBR is to replace nitrile rubber and enhance physical and chemical properties. The history of NBR can be traced back between 1914 and 1922, when the price of nitrile rubber fluctuated from 11.5 cents as to as high as $1.02 per pound. The supply from Asia faced shortage in 1925, and the price of nitrile rubber reached $1.12 per pound. In response to severe shortage, Germans and American companies started to research on synthetic rubber as a potential alternative. Finally, the first successful synthetic rubber, buna, was patented by Germany's IG Farben industry in 1926. You may not recognize this company, but you have probably heard of its successor such as BASF and Bayer. Meanwhile, in the US, DuPont's Arnold Collins has successfully developed polychloroprene rubber in 1929, which is now known as neoprene. The new material was commercialized in 1933. Several American rubber companies also began to develop a copolymer rubber of their own, such as Goodyear's Hemigun and BF Goodrich's Emerypol. Standard Oil has all its own brand. In the meantime, developed butyl rubber in 1937. The most notable discovery during 1930s was IG Farben's teams polymerizing the synthetic rubber called buna-s, formed butadiene and styrene in an aqueous emulsion, currently known as styrene butadiene rubber (SBR), widely used in the tire. Buna-s has been produced in large quantities in Germany by 1935. IG Farben scientists also developed nitrile rubber buna-n in 1931 and began its mass production in 1935, laying the cornerstone of NBR. During the World War II, Nazi Germany prevented the export of NBR to UK and the United States. Hence, Standard Oil and other companies licensed by IG Farben start their own NBR production. After World War II, IG Farben defunct and they were separated into multiple companies. The brand buna was licensed to Bayer, and eventually in 2005, Bayer strategically spun off nitrile rubber to Lanxess. In 2016, Lanxess and Saudi Aramco formed a joint venture company called Lanxeal and continue to produce nitrile rubber and under the trademark of buna-n. Besides these companies we just mentioned, there are many major nitrile producers such as Young Chemicals or JSR Corp. Let's just take a quick look on the list. NBR is a copolymer that contains two types of monomer, butadiene and acrylonitrile. The name buna comes the first two letters of butadiene and nitrile, respectively. Nitrile in German is sodium. It's because NBR was made by polymerizing the monomer butadiene in the presence of sodium. Despite the infinite number of variation in NBR, there are basically three major attributes resulting in this unlimited creation. Since NBR is a copolymer containing two types of monomer, the ratio of these monomers become critical to its properties. Let's dive a little bit deeper into this. Firstly, the polymer synthesis level. The ACN content is typically described as the acrylonitrile content or ACN content of the polymer chain. The ACN content ranging from 18% to 50%. The higher ACN content, the better fuel and oil resistance level is. The most common imbalance grade of NBR contains 36% of ACN. Secondly, the curing system. Standard NBR is sulfur cured due to its butadiene and unsaturated structure. Small amount of sulfur with aggressive accelerator is the most cost-effective way to cure NBR. The organic peroxide curing system also can improve compression say at 150 degrees C, especially when being used with coagents such as TAIC and TAC. The third factor is filler and additive, like all the other rubbers. Filler and other additives can significantly enhance NBR's chemical and physical performance. We will elaborate more about compounding ingredient in other episodes. Now just note that common ingredient includes accelerator, antioxidant, filler, retardant, process oils. By adding these ingredients into the formulation process, we can create different compounds which are used in different applications. Because the oil and fuel and heat resistant feature of NBR has made its elastomer very important to automotive non-tire industry and industrial rubber applications. NBR is considered to be the major oil, fuel, and heat resistance material in the world. It is commonly used in automotive industry, ranging from hydraulic hoses, fuel and oil supply hoses, seals, rollers, drive belts, to fabric linens and gaskets. As we can see in this chart, in addition, the increasing prevalence of lightweight vehicles boosts the automotive industry demand of nitrile rubber. NBR-based seal and O-rings, hoses, and other oil hard and gas hardware goods are significantly consumed in oil and gas application, owing to their high oil and fuel resistance. These are the two major industries using NBR. And our final note on NBR is, besides automotive and energy application, glove and medical devices can also play an important role on nitrile consumption. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click the like button and subscribe to our channel. In the next episode, we'll focus more on seals and O-rings application and the design consideration for nitrile rubber. See you next time.